What's up, guys, and welcome back to another Man vs. Deer video. In today's video, we are going to see if we can restore these antlers. We're going to try and bring this Missouri behemoth back to life. Let's get after it.
This is probably one of my bigger bucks to date.
Guys, I cannot believe that that actually worked.
Looks like a double long shot.
It was hot. Really hot.
What's up, guys, and welcome back to the channel. If you're new to the channel, make sure to smack that subscribe button, definitely like the video, and for sure leave a comment. I love hearing from you guys. So today, like I said earlier, we're going to be taking this behemoth of a buck and we're gonna be trying to restore the antlers on it. So as you can tell, it's a little bit bleached from the sun. There's a few spots where the squirrels have started to chew on it that we're gonna try and patch, mostly on this side here. And then once that's done, we're going to try and put some color back into these antlers. And then lastly, we're gonna do a crown mount on it. There's not a whole lot left of this skull to be saved. So we're gonna do a crown mount and we're gonna see if we can't make this thing look good. So before I jump into the rest of the video, I gotta give credit where credit is due. I did a lot of research into how to restore antlers, and a lot of the knowledge that I gained and that I found was actually from the Whitebone Creations YouTube channel. So I'm going to link that channel here. If you guys are into European mounts, antler restoration, things like that, that channel is a great resource for all things antler related. That guy's really good at what he does, and he has a wealth of knowledge. So make sure you check that out if you're into that kind of thing. But that's where I got a lot of the techniques that I'm going to try to employ on this set of antlers here. I have done a little bit of work to this deadhead already. So yesterday I actually got this thing out and there was a lot of moss and stuff built up on the outside of the antlers. This thing sat outside for a long time. And so what I actually did yesterday was I power washed it with the least aggressive tip on there and just got a lot of that debris and that mold and those lichens and stuff like that that have built up on those antlers over time. I washed them all off of there and I also cleaned the skull too. So we've got a nice clean surface that we're working with now. To begin the repair process, the first thing I'm gonna do is address these little holes right here where the squirrels have kind of chewed on these antlers right here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take some fix-it stick, which is basically like a two-part epoxy or a two-part compound. And I'm going to try and mold basically like finish off the tips of these antlers and fill in the cracks where some of these squirrels have chewed these antlers. And there's one little one over here. And basically what I do is I take this out, I roll it around in my hand until it gets uniformly in color. I put it on there and it's supposed to dry and harden in minutes. I'm gonna have a little glass of water nearby. So if there's any rough edges, I can just kind of dip my finger in it and smooth it out. But that's how we're gonna start this project. Let's get after it. All right, so time for some updates. It's about a day and a half later, and this two-part compound I used, the reason it took so long to dry, I'm thinking, is because I used a lot of water to smooth it out and apply it to get it to stick to the antler. And whereas that made it apply and stick very good, it did make it take a little while to dry. So it's about a day and a half later, it finally dried. And then I've also did a little bit of other work to it in the meantime. So after it dried, I took some fine sandpaper, like some 220 grit sandpaper, and I basically smoothed the edges of where this compound was on the antler, and right in here. I actually rebuilt that tip. That whole tip is compound, two-part compound. But anyways, I took some sandpaper and I smoothed out all the excess to where it looks like it's just the antler. And then after I did that, I actually took some wall joint compound or some lightweight spackling, and I took it and I ran it down the length of the entire antler because there was some cracks and stuff in the actual antler that were very, very small but still noticeable. And that lightweight spackling filled in those cracks nicely. And then I took that same piece of sandpaper and just ran it down the antler the next day to get any excess off. And that leads us to where we're at right now. To my knowledge, I've got every crack filled and the compound is on there and sanded to where it looks like it's just a part of the antler. And this is where we're at. The next step in this process, which I'm gonna do here in a minute, is we are going to take some spray paint, some latex spray paint. It's in matte white, and it's a paint and primer all in one. And I'm going to paint all of the antlers. The skull I don't care about, but the antlers, I'm going to paint them completely white, which is going to give us a fresh new surface for our stain to stick to. So we're going to get after that. All right, so I've allowed these things to dry overnight and they are a matte white all over. And I can still see some lines and striations in the antler where I maybe should have spent a little bit more time with the putty, but this is a learning process, so we'll do better on that next time. The next step in this process is to take a stain that matches the color of the antlers in your area. For me, that looks like Special Walnut number 224. And I actually had a buck that I shot this year that when I euro mounted it, I got some peroxide on the antlers and I used it to bring the color back in them. It worked really well. So I'm basically just going to take a small brush, and I'm not worried about the skull because I'm going to cut the skull off on this one and make a crown mat afterwards. But normally, if you were restoring like a deadhead and you wanted to keep the skull, you'd tape it off or you'd put a bag around it or something to keep that stain from getting to it, because if the stain touches the skull, it's that color forever. But in my case, I'm not worried about it because I'm going to cut it off. But I'm basically just going to stain the entire antler. And I'll probably have to do several different coats of that in order to get it to the desired darkness. And I'm going to do one layer per day. So I'm going to put a layer on today and let it dry. And then I'll probably repeat the next, repeat that the next day. And then maybe again a third day until it gets the exact color I want. But I'm going to get this first color of stain on these antlers. All right, guys, time for another update. So this is where we're at. And I did a little bit more than put one coat of stain on it. So I'm gonna kind of walk you through what I did over the past couple of days. So I ended up putting two different coats of the lighter stain, which was the Special Walnut 224. And then after all that was said and done, it still didn't look real to me. And I was noticing all the other antlers were darker around the bases, and it kind of like faded into a lighter color. So what I did was take a darker stain and I used Minwax Red Mahogany. It was a stain that I had on hand, and it came out
awesome looking. So this is what it looks like right now after two coats of special walnut and one coat around the bases of special mahogany. Now, when I did the coat around the bases, I feathered it into the other part using a paper towel. So basically I would use the brush to bring the stain up here and I'd wipe it off with a paper towel. I'd use the brush to bring the stain up here, not dipping it, just bringing the stain from the antler. I'd wipe it off with a paper towel, and I did that until I got a nice transition, and I would have filmed that for you guys, but it was dark. I've been doing a lot of this stuff after work. But that's what I've done in the meantime. The next thing I'm gonna do to these antlers is they've got a little bit of a sheen on them from the stain, and so I'm gonna take some steel wool and just kinda lightly go over these things until the sheen is gone. And that will basically complete what we're gonna do with the antlers. So let's get after that. We're gonna take the sheen off these. All right guys, so as far as the antlers are concerned, we are done. I used steel wool to take the sheen off of there. I went over the entire antler lightly, and I mean lightly, with a steel wool pad. Then on the burrs, because the burrs had some pretty deep little crevices in them, I took this little nylon looking toothbrush thing I have for cleaning weapons, and I went through that, and it did a real good job getting the sheen out of that. And the last thing I did was I took this steel wool again, and I went over the tips pretty aggressively because I wanted them to be really white. And that's where we are. This whole process has taken about a week. Most of that was letting stain dry and stuff, but I'm pretty pleased with the results. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take the antlers, I'm gonna cut them off right here, and I'm gonna do a crown mount, and then I will come back and give you guys my finishing thoughts on everything. All right guys, so this is it. This is the finished product, and for my first time at trying to restore antlers, I gotta say I'm pretty stoked about how it turned out, especially the transition from the darker bases to the lighter beams. I really, really like how that transition turned out. There are a couple of spots where the paint didn't want to stick, so in turn the stain did not want to stick. And if I had it to do over again, I would definitely put a second coat of paint and be more diligent while applying the first coat of paint. But all in all, for my first time, I think this turned out really, really well. And for the most part, besides those couple of spots where the paint didn't stick, I think it looks pretty natural. So really excited about how this one turned out. I'll definitely be doing more of these. I'm gonna kind of like revisit what we did in case you guys are following along and trying this at home. I'll just kind of go back through the steps in case you're writing them down or anything. But I power washed it. Then I filled the holes with a two-part compound. Then I sanded those down to where they were flush with the antler. Then I took a wall joint compound and kind of ran it up and down the antler, filling any of those hairline cracks that the sun had caused. The next day I sanded that off. Then I applied a coat of flat white latex spray paint. Then I applied a coat of stain, let it dry for a day, the light stain. Applied another coat of stain, let it dry for a day, and then I applied a darker coat of stain to the base and stopped right about where the brow tine is. And then I would take a brush and bring the stain from the brow tine up, and then I would wipe it off with a paper towel, bring it up, wipe it off with a paper towel, and that's how I kind of got it to blend from one color to the other. After I did that, I let the whole thing dry for about 5 days. Then I came back with a little thing of steel wool, and I just lightly, and I mean lightly, rubbed it all over, and that took a lot of the sheen off. Now some of the deeper parts of the antler, where the burrs are sticking out real big, I had to take a little nylon toothbrush looking thing with, and it was pretty stiff, and that let me get down into some of the cracks and crevices and take the sheen out of there. And that was pretty much it. After that I did a crown mount, which I may make another video showing you guys how I do these if you want. Actually that Whitebone Creations page that I linked early on in the video, that's where I learned how to do these from, and that guy's a great resource for all kinds of stuff, but especially Euro mounting and crown mounts and stuff like that. So make sure that you check that out if you haven't already. But this is it. And that's pretty much the end of the video, guys. I hope this video was extremely helpful. If it was, make sure you like the video. Make sure that you throw a comment down below, especially if you have any questions. And make sure you smack that subscribe button. I try to release about a video a week, so I got a constant stream of videos coming to the channel. Something else new that I'm doing, if you check the description or you check the comments of the video, I got a shop in there now, and any purchases from that shop, you just go to the description and then you click the link. Any purchases from that shop directly support the channel. And this plaque that this antler's on, that's one of the items that's in the shop. It's called the shield plaque. But make sure that you guys check that out. And I really appreciate you watching. I will catch you guys in the next one.